Hello, hello, hello. Today is Sunday, August 22nd, 2021. Hurricane Henry, with winds up to 150, 170 kilometers per hour, is about to make landfall a few hours from now. It's still a hurricane, category one, but once it makes landfall, it will become a tropical storm. The energy source of a hurricane is the warm water, and so as soon as it gets over land, it calms down somewhat. But the damage that it can cause is enormous. It's expected to reach New York City as a tropical storm about 10 hours from now. In advance of this, the governor of New York City has already declared it a state of emergency. The problem is not only the wind, but the problem is water. Huge amounts of rain that underpasses completely filled with water, houses filled with water. So the state of emergency means then that they try to minimize traffic on the streets. It's even dangerous to walk outside. The tropical storm will reach my house in Connecticut later this night, and tomorrow morning, Monday, it will hit my house in Cambridge, where my wife and I are now. By that time, the wind speeds will probably be not much more than about 100 kilometers per hour, which can cause a huge amount of damage too. It is anticipated that 50% of the people in Connecticut, which is the state where I spend most of my time at my house there, that 50% of the people will lose power, and that it may take up to 3 weeks to have all that power being restored. Cambridge, where I am now, is unlikely to get major power failures because it's much further north than Connecticut, about 100 miles, and by that time the winds still will be force and there will still be lots of rain, but not as bad as in Connecticut. There is another issue that in Connecticut all high voltage wires that provide houses with electricity through transformers are all above ground. It's all forest. My house is in a forest. And so the wind breaks the trees and breaks the branches and cuts the wires. That is much less likely here in Cambridge, where I am now. But yes, it's possible that I lose power also in Cambridge. I will go back to Connecticut tomorrow, Monday, early afternoon, just to make sure what the conditions of my house will be there. It's not clear that I can make it to Connecticut tomorrow because there may be blockage on the roads, trees may have fallen on the roads. And the highways will probably be cleared, but the smaller roads in Connecticut will not have been cleared yet. So it's not clear that I will be able to get to my house, but I will try, because surely I want to see whether there's any damage of my house in Connecticut. If there is power failure there, and if the house is in good condition, I will go back to Cambridge and spend my days here until the power has been restored at my home in Connecticut. no power in Connecticut, in my house in Connecticut. I should say our house, it's my wife's house and my house. No power at my house, at our house in Connecticut means that we have no air conditioning, we can't cook, we have no water because we have a water well. And the water well pumps the water up and the pump needs electricity. So we also have no water and we have no internet and we have no telephone. So Connecticut is in bad conditions when we have no power. And so we may lose delicate food that we have in the freezer, but we have a solution for that. We have an enormous large box. It's a special box designed to hold a huge amount of ice cubes, which we can buy. And then we put the food, the delicate food in there, and it will last 3 or 4 days. But we will come back to Cambridge then with that huge container with food. In any case, if somehow I go off the air and don't answer any questions during the next 24 hours, it means that already here in Cambridge, I lost power. It's not likely, but it is possible. The fact that the governor of New York City has called this already a state of emergency means a lot. This tells you something. It is extremely rare that hurricanes go this far north. Normally, they are much further south. Florida, Louisiana, not Connecticut, not New York City. But it happens. Don't pray for us, because I don't believe in praying, but at least appreciate the fact that, yeah, it's a little tense for us to know what's going to happen in the next 24 hours. You will read about it in newspapers, even at your home, no matter where you are in the world. I'm sure it will be covered also on radio and on the TV. You will not cover all hurricanes in the United States, but this one is so special because it comes so far north and will hit even New York City, but by that time it's no longer a hurricane, but it will be a tropical storm, which can be very, very dangerous and which can cause a huge amount of damage and destruction. Despite all this misery, have a nice day, take care, and keep us in your thoughts, not in your prayers, because I don't believe in prayers, but keep us in your thoughts. Have a nice day, and follow Hurricane Henry, which is the name, Henry, follow it on the news. We'll be friends. That's always a fact. That's always a given.